This is the SF Productions Podcast Network.
Good evening and welcome to another exciting episode of Vast Wasteland.
Secret Square. Could it be Bob Denver, Karen Valentine, Walt, the cast of Soap, Henry Winkler, Mr. Ed and Wilbur, Marty J. Wiley, Mark Schnidbauer, and in the center square, Wilbert Neal. All on the new
is Tuesday at 6, Wednesdays at 10, Thursdays at 3. That Darren Pamela Ferdin. No, not another Burgess Meredith show.
Welcome to the place your parents didn't understand.
The world of 60s and 70s television.
Welcome to Vast Wasteland.
Welcome home.
Hello and welcome to Vast Wasteland, the video journal of popular culture. I'm Mark Schmidbauer along with Wilbert Neal and Marty Willow. Well, tonight we're going to talk about shows that we, the cast of Vast Wasteland, make a point to go see.
The real must-see TV.
The real must-see TV, as far as we're concerned. There you go.
You know, when they started running that must-see TV, and it sounded like they were saying wussy TV.
It doesn't sound like musty TV.
Musty
TV.
Musty. Well, I'm not watching wussy shows.
And I'm not going to watch something so old that it's musty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Stink up my TV.
So, anyways, that's what we're talking about tonight. But first off, we want to tell you that we're on Wednesdays at 10, and Thursdays at 3, and Saturdays, if they feel like it, down at the old City Hall.
Necessary.
That's right. Oops, somebody didn't turn in the show. What is Vast Wasteland? And if you want to write into us, it's Box 151411, Columbus, Ohio, 43215. Or if you want to email us, there's an email address, fastw@copyserve.com. And there's a web address. Blah 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 blah.
Thank you, Charlie Brown teacher.
The Miss Othmar reading. There you go. So
did they all have the same teacher on that show?
Othmar.
I think so. I think it's Miss Othmar. I don't remember there being a different teacher.
It was a very progressive kind of school that just threw the kids into one room.
Yeah, schoolhouse thing.
Well, but it was there were like 20 kids in town, apparently. You know, even if you got the obscure ones.
Even if you're bringing the babies at home.
Yeah.
Which they're doing now.
Yep.
How old is that kid, rerun?
He's baby.
Yeah, he's still the baby.
He's still the baby? Yeah. Okay, hadn't gone to school yet.
Baby.
Yeah, so he's still got the big head.
Well, they all do.
Well, I mean, but, you know, when they're babies, they had bigger heads.
Big head.
They'd make comments about putting on a hat and he'd fall over. He's so big. It'd unbalance him or something.
That's real life.
Right. Hi, Freemus! Hi, Freemus!
Freemus is our dog. He wants to play a cruel trick on him. Because Freebus has started watching TV.
That reminds me. Later in the show, get your cameras ready. We're going to do yet another in the series of collectible...
Trading cards.
Trading cards. Autographed cards. What you want to do is get your camera ready. We're going to put ourselves into a still shot, and you can take a picture of it. Send it in to us, and we'll autograph it.
And we'll send it back.
And we'll send it back. Yeah, we'll autograph it and then throw it away. No. There you go.
And keep it.
Yeah. So get your cameras ready for that. Anyways, the topic tonight, again, the shows that we make it a point to see, the real must-see TV.
According to we.
According to we.
Okay. Must see every night, 7 o'clock, Monday through Friday, Jeopardy.
Jeopardy. Now, personally, that's when I watch the rerun of The Daily Show for the night before.
Oh, but see, I can watch that. I can watch the fresh one at 11, so. But now it's even better because it's a whole hour now because you've got Jeopardy, and then right after Jeopardy, you turn over to Ben Stein's Money.
Mm-hmm.
So you get this whole hour of like being smart.
Yeah, the being smart.
No, because if you just want a great game show block, I mean you can turn on that wheel show.
Right. No. These are
intelligent shows.
I want an interactive thing with the Wheel of Fortune.
Yeah.
I want this new interactive. They do all this interactive TV stuff. And this is for people like me who get really frustrated by the Wheel of Fortune because it's so obvious.
Mm-hmm.
I want to be able to shoot players who buy vowels. You know. I want to, and basically, you know, they just lose a limb or something, you know. But every time they buy a value, boom!
Well, just paint splat them, you know.
Yeah. Just blow a little hole in them, you know.
Yeah.
Just
virtual paint.
Just so they can check the monitor and see that people have been shooting at them.
Yeah.
Because and then when they blow it, you know, just blow an obvious.
Yeah.
You know, they buy the vowel and it's the vowel that's already up there, or they just totally blow the entire puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
Then you just get to waste them for just...
Right.
You know, it call it the gene pool game. I don't know. It's just, you know.
Mucking out the gene pool.
shouldn't be allowed to breed if you mess up a Wheel of Fortune.
Well, for those who don't know about Ben Stein's Money, it's over there on it's over there in the old Comedy Central, and the idea of this show is that Ben puts up $5,000 of his own money each night.
Hi.
And people try.
I'm Ben Stein. And tonight,
anyone?
I'm going to make history. I'm going to put up $5,000 of my own money. So if you're good enough, smart enough, and fast enough, and if you've got the guts, you could win Ben Stein's money.
And this is a show done with no technology. You can,
right.
They're doing it the old Jeopardy style, where they're dropping the cards into the...
Shakunk.
Now, I have noticed something by watching both shows. I will get answers from a Jeopardy show, and that question will come up on Ben Stein within the next week or so. And also, Jeopardy is trying to get more clever, because the thing with Ben Stein that makes it really enjoyable is they use a lot of puns in their categories.
Right.
They get real silly with them. They get a little risque.
Yes.
Jeopardy is now trying to do that.
Yeah, I think so.
They really have started to do that.
Because you got to remember,
is fine.
This is, you know, the 7 to 8 slot is when Jeopardy is shown throughout most of the country. You know, and that's 7:30. That's when Ben Stein's Money's on.
And they did something really goofy the other night on Jeopardy. They had a celebrity thing. And at one point, it came back, and Alex Trebek was talking like a munchkin or something because one of the contestants told him to do it, and he did it. He came back. Okay, now, yeah, got it.
And you were going, Alex, please, no.
We thought something was terribly wrong with the sound or something. But
we thought the TV was broken.
Or he had taken some helium or something. But he
Alex
was like,
boom,
hit the side
Alex
of the
Trebek.
TV.
Cause when
that's all we need.
Because, I mean, he's an intelligent guy, but when he sits there and he's humorous, it just hits you and strikes you. Wait a minute. What's
he
doing?
Was silly.
Yeah, but I mean, to get downright silly. That was really scary.
Yes.
That was very scary. So you mentioned another one that's a must-see.
The Daily. The Daily Show. It's the kids call it on the street, The Daily.
It's the cast and crew of Bass Wasteland.
Yeah.
The Daily.
It's a half-hour show of a... it's like
tabloid TV.
News satire show.
Yeah.
And just a very... sarcastic tone to the whole thing.
And I've got to know where they got the shot for five questions, where the guy is smashing the head. I've got to see the whole movie. I think it's just that tease every night. I'm so intrigued. But yeah, that one, try to watch, try to stay up until 11, because you know the 11 o'clock news is going to be the same old stuff.
Yeah.
And even there, they try to do something to zing you each night, but it just doesn't work.
No.
Right.
No. Of course, the best night was when Night Beat came on, and the screen was black for the first 5 minutes of this news, local newscast. Yeah. They're called Night Beat.
Well, we're showing the night. There it is.
And
black.
It was dark, so I was like, whoa, concept here. Black screen and news.
Wow.
It was the first night I watched it. I thought it was going to be like, you know, the concept. And then they were like, oh, wait, we're having technical problems. No, you're not.
No.
Fine.
It's the goth news.
So, yeah.
Well, a show that I certainly make a point to see and been watching it since it came on again, another Comedy Central show now over on Sci-Fi Channel, is the old Mystery Science Theater 3000.
You are like the original dyed-in-the-wool MSTK man.
Yes. I've been to both of the convention cons up there in Minneapolis.
This man flew to the premiere of the movie.
Yeah.
They
weren't showing the movie here in Columbus, so a friend of mine and I actually flew to Minneapolis.
To be at the gala opening.
It wasn't at the gala opening. It was just showing.
The gala second night.
It was like we just went to go see it. We flew up to Minneapolis, went to go see the movie, went to the Mall of America for an hour, and then went back and jumped on a plane and flew back here.
You know how to live wild.
Yeah.
Slave to pop culture here.
The amazing frequent flyer miles. I'm telling you. So it was, now. They've kind of, I think they've gotten their second wind back on the show now. They were kind of like in a funk there for a while.
Yeah.
You know, it was kind of like a parallel of Joel leaving and Mike being there. I'm kind of like when Trapper left MASH and BJ was there, you know. I think they've finally gotten their act together. And
now they're time traveling, too,
yeah,
aren't they?
Because
I've popped in on
They're going into wormholes.
Yeah.
They've been
they're really taking
Rome,
advantage of being in space now.
Yeah, finally. Yeah. They visited the Planet of the Apes and So now the new season actually begins. Well, for it's going to begin like second week in March, so it'll be like
very soon.
Season
now.
9.
Very soon. Do not call Mark.
That's right.
Second week
I'm watching
of March.
MSD.
And don't call me at 7 o'clock any night because I will hang up on you. I'm watching Jeopardy.
Yes.
And then, well, you go back to Comedy Central. Show everybody's making a point to watch. South Park. We're now in cliffhanger time now. We got to find out who the fat kid's dad is. And I'm really surprised there's not more time. I mean, people used to say, oh, who shot JR? Ooh, who shot JR? You know, and I thought this would be the who shot JR. But people are almost afraid to talk about South Park. At least in the circles I'm in, it's like, do you watch that show? Did you see the one with the pig and elephant? Yeah, and?
Hi-yee-haw!
That's 10 o'clock, you know, that's the time period.
Right.
When it's on, when it's fresh.
Right.
Even the reruns.
Oh, yes, that's nice and fresh, just like flour.
Please smack him, because I can't reach him.
All right, well, speaking of that's quasi-cartoon. I don't know. I don't know if it's really
it's
a cartoon.
It's cartoon on a budget.
It's animated.
It's really
not a
cartoon.
We don't have cartoons anymore. We have animation.
Well,
if it's Japanese, it's anime.
Anime. Well, another spin-off of
and
the whole...
And it's French, it's anime.
Old spin-off of another animation piece is that darn space goes coast to coast.
Coast to coast. Try to catch that.
And of course, the split-up with that in Cartoon Planet. So,
yeah.
Now, for those of you who haven't seen this show... I you know, highly recommend you go over there to the old Cartoon Network and see this.
That's when you make a point to see.
That's right.
You make a point to
point to see Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
That's when I'm like, it's midnight and I'm playing. Oh, Space Ghost, something I recognize.
Well, the idea is...
It's not the news.
They've taken all the stock shots from the old Space Ghost show and they put them in a talk show set. And they have, like, real live guests come in as on a little TV set that comes down. And
John Henson, I think, was one of the best I had seen. Because you have to go in there with the attitude. And he had the attitude. Weird Al was pretty good, but Weird Al's out there anyway.
Well, Charlton Heston was on recently.
I did see the Charlton.
And it was just like, you could tell he just didn't get the whole thing. It was just like, somebody's agent, you know, right after that show, some agent was buying a big dinner. Either buying a big dinner or checking the one hand. Because it was like, how dare you book me for this?
Okay, bad daytime habits. I know yours, and you can't deny it. If I'm home, 1 o'clock on my children. You know, I'll take you on, people, young and the restless people. Yeah, come on. All my children. I don't know so much if I'm following the story, if it's just a habit, and I have to check in on these people, make sure they're okay.
Yeah.
You know, started years ago and had a baby, and it was time to nurse the baby, and that's what's on TV. So, bad daytime habit. Come on.
Okay, we've got kind of a guilty pleasure at work, and we all come in and talk about it. That darn Jerry Springer. If we're home, we will watch Springer.
And if they're not home, they will tape it so they can watch it.
We've got one coworker who will tape it and bring it in for us to watch. And we do have a bootleg of the Too Hot for TV Springer. It shows just something. It makes you feel
it's
good
like
about
you put
where
money
you
on
are
where
in
you
life.
Are as opposed to these people who are on the show.
Who's gonna throw the first punch? Yeah. Oh, I see, is that one there?
And how are they gonna do it? Is it gonna be a head-on punch? Is it gonna be a sneak punch?
Or are they gonna hit him with a chair?
Are they gonna come up behind him and just smack him upside the head and then just leave? Or what's gonna happen? It's always fun. Yep. And then there's the surprise punches sometimes too.
I have managed to make it through one Springer show.
I think that's a show that is eminently possible for a drinking game. You know?
Oh yeah.
You can depending on the type of, you know, when the hits occur and what kind of hit it is, you have to, you know.
You take a shot.
Or everybody can just call a punch. I get the bitch slap.
Yeah. You each pick. You know, each pick
I get
one
the punch.
Of the, one of the cast members.
I get the tackle.
You know.
The roundhouse.
Whoever gets hit, you have to take them.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
Hair pull. I get hair pull. Yeah. Oh, you always get hair pull. You know.
Hair pull, hair of the dog. You know.
Now. Oh, well, the only show that I'm, if I'm home, to make a point of to see during the daytime is that old Price is Right. That's the show I like watching. No. I've been watching that show forever.
Well, I'll throw all the hair changes.
Yeah, all the hair changes. Bob's hair changes, you know. And I've gotten very good at the pricing game.
I got quit
over the years.
You guys.
Over the years. I'm telling
just waiting
you.
For your yeah, chance.
Waiting we'll my chance. The... Sometime I'm going to be out in California. I'm going to the Price is Right and clean up.
You know, because you know as soon as they call you up to the thing, you're gonna be sitting there waiting. That's going to be a brand new car!
I can see Mark get up there and say, come on, throw any game at me.
Throw any game. I can do it.
I got it.
And you'll probably get the big coin game.
Oh, Plinko. Oh, I hate Plinko.
That's the only
and
one
I can
you
see you saying that. No, I'm not Plinko.
Because that's the game that they expect you to get up there and go, oh, no. Oh. They expect you to jump around and be crazy about it. That's how they choose the people.
Well, that's
for
how they
that
get
one.
People on there. Yeah. Yeah, you had to just go in dressed like a chicken or something.
Yeah. You can't. Oh, that's let's make a deal.
Well, but they're getting that bad, though.
Oh,
they're almost getting that bad on Price because it's like it's.
The last lineup I saw looked like Trailer Trash City.
Yeah. And it's like everybody has a T-shirt that has some Bob Barker slogan on it or something. It's like,
or, you know, they go from Springer to the Price is Right.
I think it's the same audience. I don't know.
I'm sorry, we can't use it in Springer show. How about going down to the Price is Right?
I don't know.
You'll have somebody showing up there with Soy Mom.
Yeah. Well, okay. Well, a show that I certainly make a point to see is over there on Fox. Really, the only Fox show that I make a real point of seeing is Simpsons.
Simpsons, Simpsons.
You know.
And King of the Hill.
Now you've got
to follow up the hour.
I've started watching King of the Hill. I was avoiding it for a while just because it was, you know, that
a Mike Judge phobia or something.
You know, I just was like, yeah. But actually, the show isn't too bad. It's starting to grow on me.
I'll tell you what, it's not a bad show at all. Well, you got that old Daniels and then Boomhauer and Dale and then Bill, and then they just sit around there in a day where they do the big old show about nothing.
Well, and then over on Saturday mornings, really, as far as I'm concerned, the only network, because the main networks have basically abandoned Saturday morning traditional programming.
Yeah.
So, you know, in my opinion, you really got to be over in the old kids WB. Because that's personal opinion.
I think I picked that up on Sunday.
Yeah, you've got that. You've got your Animaniacs and Piggy in the Brain.
Yeah. But see, I like round out the Sunday morning with starting off with Bozo out of Chicago, and
right.
then they run the WB.
Oh, yeah.
So it like makes a nice Sunday with donuts and coffee, you know, donuts and tea or whatever your thing is.
Because you got your Piggy in the Brain, you got your Animaniacs,
your Batman and Superman.
Batman and Superman thing.
And they always say Tweety the Laugh, so you can turn it off.
Superman again.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you watch the whole thing from the very beginning, you see at least two episodes of Piggy in the Brain.
Two Piggy in the Brain.
Two episodes of Superman.
You got your Men in Black in there.
Which is the only, they could throw that one out. I'm not
Oh, that's one that's
that
probably,
one.
It's either going to last a season,
yeah.
or they're going to get better
right.
as it goes along.
Right.
But
we're starting to make a point of seeing Silver Surfer.
Yeah, I like the Silver Surfer.
I
new one.
The
new one on Fox.
Yeah.
And it's not bad. They, of course, if you're doing the big comparison between comic and show, it's like, oh, they've messed this all up. But taken just as itself, it's not bad.
Yeah.
And it's getting better as it goes along. It's just been on a few weeks now, but by the time this is showing, it will have been on for probably a couple months.
Yeah.
But,
One thing, I think something they've been doing at Animaniacs recently has been this thing where they're loaning the Warners out to other studios.
They're doing the
they've
parody.
Like, well, yeah,
did
they,
you see the Rugrat one?
Yeah. Well, they did this whole thing where there was like Warner Brothers needed some extra money at certain times after a big flop movie, so they loaned the Warners out to other animation studios. So there was like this Underdog parody and a Scooby Doo parody and
Yogi Bear one.
Yeah. And a they're like,
did you see the trash work they did on Disney though?
Oh yeah.
The same old heroin. That is just like, wow, yes.
Yeah. Oh yeah, they've slammed Disney.
They've slammed them very
times.
Heavily, yeah,
several
with
times.
The Lion King parody stuff and, but the one where Dot was doing all the heroin, they recycled heroin, just
the same, the
turning
same
into
story.
Everything.
Yeah.
It's the same story. It's the same. We still make the same. I thought, ooh, you know, how you don't get sued, I don't know, but hey, go. It's, you know, I love it. I love it.
People love parody.
We're tied into a couple of the late night soap operas, basically the Practice, the ER,
and NYPD
the NYPD Blue.
Blue.
Pretty much by the time everybody's home from work and can sit down, so those are like the only network things that are really well. Drew, you try to catch Drew.
Yeah, we try to catch Drew when we can.
Frasier.
Yeah.
Third Rock.
Although Frasier, more and more, seems to me like they're starting to recycle Are You Being Served scripts. Is it just me? Because it's like there's like somebody has some sort of miscommunication and somebody has like an ailment that day. Like the dad can't hear, or Niles like last night was a... had like he kept having kept falling asleep
and the narcolepsy happened.
Yeah, and it's like
it woke us in bed
wackiness ensues, you know. So I don't know, it's still a good show, but
I'm getting very hooked on trying to make a point to see Dharma and Greg though.
I like that.
I really have gotten caught on Dharma and Greg, even though they're always in bed. I still try to watch Dharma and Greg. I mean, I'm trying to see what's going to happen with this show when Dharma and Greg can't do it anymore or something.
Well, there's News Radio, which I really
like. Oh, yeah, News Radio.
But it's just become so surrealistic.
Yes. Yeah. Matthew is a dentist.
Yeah.
And he looks like Herbie.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Wait a minute.
And then...
And Third Rock, you mentioned.
Just Shoot Me, that's one.
That show's starting to grow, I think.
Yeah, it's one.
Oh,
I mean, it just runs in between, you know.
Because it ran in between something before.
Yeah, that was like filler,
watching.
You know.
Yeah, it was a filler show.
Must-see filler.
Yeah, but it's proved itself, so it now can kind of stand on its
right.
own.
Yeah.
And I don't really like David Spade. I'd kind of like to hit him, you know?
Well, that's the character that he plays well
but,
on this.
But I like him, though, on this. It's like, and George Siegel is just wonderful on this show. They've got a very good cast on that show. It's with those ensemble.
Oh,
well, I was thinking about this before the show, and I could only think of one show on CBS that I would even make a point of, and that's George and Leo. But other than that, because it's Bob Newhart, and I would watch anything that has Bob Newhart in it, as far as I'm concerned. But
I don't think that even turned.
But that's like the only, maybe Monday night's the only time I would regularly turn CBS on. That's it.
I don't think that one's on our channel anymore.
Murphy Brown still on?
I have no, I don't think so. I don't even know if it's still on.
They were saying it is.
Jeopardy was saying it was. So it must still be running.
Somewhere.
Well, and then, to certainly get into, you want to go fully on the side of the escapist type stuff and just complete silliness, you got to go over to that darn Hercules and Xena.
Don't make it a big point, but yeah.
But it's like,
musical kind of, I have to rest from that.
It has gotten so campy. It's very close. I mean, I'm really expecting, you know, special guest star, best villain, you know. Same Xena time, same Xena
After
channel.
After the Xena musical, I've had to take a break. The musical kind of did me in.
The Hercules last week was, they actually had the whole episode in modern day, and it's the producing staff of Hercules, and they can't find the guy who's Kevin Sorbo, that guy. And it's all the people who are in the show who are playing the producers of the show. And all of it is just an excuse to do a clip show. That's all it is.
Okay.
It's just
wildest stretch to do a clip
show. Yeah.
Okay, one more show we do make it a point to watch every single week. Dennis Miller live. As long as Dennis is on, we're there. Yeah. Don't always agree with Dennis, but it's something about the rant. Yeah. I'm hooked on the rant and the big pictures. Usually don't care too much who the guest is. Sharon Stone absolutely sucked up the show bad. Usually has pretty good people. But got to see the rant and got to see the pictures at the end.
Well, then there is one more, too. That is Mad TV.
Mad TV.
Just some humorous things happen on Mad TV. Okay.
Well, finally, you got it. Just, and if there's nothing else on, you can always turn to TV Land. So,
Family Affair.
Yeah, Hogan's Heroes. There
My
you go.
Three sons. Yeah.
White Shadow.
And of course, if there's absolutely anything comes to anything, there's always Ally McBeal. Well, there, we've mentioned
there
it a few times,
exactly,
haven't we?
Exactly. So there you go.
That's, I guess, our must-see.
The list.
We did make a chart.
Yeah. Check your local listing.
So we just kind of jumped around there.
Jumping around. There you go. So,
we got a freeze frame. We said we would.
Oh, that's right. Got to do a freeze frame. Get your cameras ready. Here we go. Here we go. And go.
I'm rambling.
Okay. Okay. Send that in, and we'll autograph it for you.
We warned you, so you should have been ready.
Yeah, if you weren't ready, not our problem. So, for all of us here at Vast Wasteland, we'll see you next time. Good out of the butter!
I told you what to watch.
Yeah,
now
so
watch.
Go watch it.